Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Colonel Robert Parker from Bucksport, Tennessee, from the Spurs. His tag team partner from Portland.
And tonight on WCW Saturday Night, we will be seeing Paul Orndorff taking on Sting. Second round of the U.S. Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Let's go back to our ring announcer.
Your opponents in this feature matchup from Hollywood, California, weighing 233 pounds, Ryan! This champion from the Kentucky, Georgia, weighing 232 pounds, Johnny B. Stone!
This should be a fast and furious tag team match. Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater against the Flying Brian and Johnny B. Bad. All four of these men are very fast in the ring.
Well, you know what, guys? I think what's going to dictate this is what you said, the pace of the match. Obviously, if Johnny Bad and Pillman get into a fist-fight ball with Slater and Bunkhouse Buck, which they would like them to do, that's what Parker would like them to do, then they're going to be in the short end of the stick, brother. But I believe if they dazzle them with a little footwork, you know what I mean? Dream punch is always open, brother.
Well, I know exactly what you mean, but Dirty Dick and Bunkhouse Buck, I can tell you what their strategy is going to be right now. They're going to try to slow this match down. They're going to try to suck Johnny B. Bad and Flying Brian over into their corner, control the tempo of this match, and I think that's what's going to happen right here. Experience shall overcome the Flyers.
Well, Slammery weekend. Great weekend. Great matchup here. You can feel the electricity in the arenas of WCW.
Can indeed. And, of course, seeing tag team action right now reminds me that tomorrow night, the Nasty Boys get their final opportunity for the World Tag Team Championship against the Harlem Heat, who they're managed by Sister Sherry, of course.
Well, we talked about it. Like I said, you know, I just believe that the time for getting it on is getting it on. I mean, business is business. Let's take care of business. Right here, see the first lockup right here. Johnny B. Bad gotten. See what happens. Ooh.
By the way, the main event tomorrow night will be coming direct from St. Pete as well, and then we'll cut into the pay-per-view at 7 o'clock.
Yes, it's going to be a tremendous thing. All the fans around the world on TBS can see that big main event, getting ready to go in and getting that pay-per-view television there, calling the operator and getting it. Well, you seen, you know, Larry, they were getting ready to go toe-to-toe with a fist of cuff. I know Dick Slater got a powerful punch. I know that, but I don't know if you want to get in a fist fight with the dream punch of Johnny B. Bad.
Well, Slater, he knows what he's doing in there. If you noticed, about a minute ago, you know, he took Johnny B. Bad down, trying to keep him on the match, slow the match down, but Johnny B. Bad reversed it on him, but I still think Slater's going to stick to the same strategy.
Off the rope, Slater misses with the right hand. Johnny B. Bad gets a full scoop slam on the young man from Port Tampa. See if the tag is made. I don't know. Yep, Bunkhouse Buck.
Yeah, they're going to discuss their strategy plans right here. These guys are not going to rush into Johnny B. Bad and Flying Brian. They're going to take their time. They're in no hurry. It doesn't matter how long it takes you. It's only important if you win.
I'm surprised that Johnny B. Bad, Flying Brian have let Bunkhouse Buck and Dick Slater set the pace in this match.
Well, it's hard to make guys move. I mean, if you're in with another guy who likes to wrestle with that type of pace, is one thing. But when you're in there with guys like Bunkhouse Buck, Dirty Dick, they know they're not as fast as these guys. They know they can't get in the ropes and outfly Brian. So they're going to, look, I mean, how are you going to get Bunkhouse Buck out of that corner if you don't want to go?
Yeah, but I agree with God. You can't let the other team dictate what you're going to do. If you got a game plan and you can fly and you can move around and you can drop kick, back salt, somersault, flip off the top of the turnbuckle, off the building, through the front door, then that's what you got to do.
Yeah, but flying out the front door ain't going to do you no good if your opponent is hugging the turnbuckle.
Well, if I'm hitting a guy with a drop kick and he's flying out the front door, I'll be parading out there in the middle of the ring. That's what I'll be doing.
If you could hit someone with a drop kick, we'd all be parading.
Yeah, well, I can't hear. Let me get up here. We got room here.
I can throw
a drop kick.
But calm down, fellas.
I can get up right here.
The midget.
Yeah. Flying Brian.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Stand up. Let's throw it.
Gentlemen, please.
Talking to you, Gordon.
Right. But Bunkhouse Buck coming up with a couple of knees to the midsection now of Flying Brian. Trying to take away some of that oxygen. And Flying Brian moves up on the top rope, comes around once again. He's set and ready. Flies off the top, catches Bunkhouse Buck. Now, Flying Brian beginning to establish the pace here, and he has changed it up quite a bit. Johnny B. Badd tags in, catches Bunkhouse Buck in the side of the ribcage. Alarm Dragon twist now by Johnny B. Badd. They picked up the tempo.
You know what, Gunn? I used to have two type of boots. I had my drop kicking boots, and I would wear them at night when I would go and drop kick. And I had my high kicking boots, and I wore my high kicking boots a lot longer than I did my drop kicking boots. And I can say high. I can't say boogers and stuff on here, but I can say high.
Colonel Parker looking somewhat upset right now. Johnny B. Badd fired off the ropes. Nice counter by Johnny B. Badd. Counter by Bunkhouse Buck. Johnny B. Badd go behind and a nice takedown.
You're right there, Johnny B. Badd, using his speed and stuff, but ring positioning ever so important, and he did not know where he was at. Dirty Dick Slater taking advantage of it. Look, he's trying to push him back in that corner. Hey, that's a fist.
Sure is a fist, and Slater started it, and Johnny B. Badd finished it.
That's a good call by Larry. That was a fist.
Into a hammerlock now by Johnny B. Badd. Wide stance, traps the near leg.
Well, he's controlled. You know, I really believe that Pillman ain't been in there yet, you know. I mean, he's been in there about short periods of time and an introduction and stuff. But he needs to really, really, I mean, when I mean being in there, he needs to really fire it up.
Oh,
that caught him right in the mush.
Well, that's a big mistake. You've got to make a lot of tags, even more than you think is necessary. And Johnny B. Badd, well, finally he made one, but he was starting to get wobbly.
And Pillman catches one in the back of the head for his trouble in coming into the ring. Slater dragging Pillman back toward his own corner, has him bent back over the top rope. A big Johnny Valentine forearm across the chest.
You know, God, we were talking about that big main event live right before that pay-per-view tomorrow on TBS. This man right here, Pillman and Ming, match it up. U.S. tournament second round. I'm going to tell you what. You talk about hot and heavy. This whole Slammery weekend just got me excited.
Talk about tonight, of course, with the first, second round of the U.S. Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Then tomorrow night, another round. And tonight, of course, it's going to be...
And a matter of fact, excuse me, God, I'll have a round. Give me another round.
Yeah, that wouldn't be bad.
The second round's coming up. We're starting to get rid of some of the dead wood, so it's going to get nice and exciting now.
I was in Deadwood years ago.
You left?
Oh, yeah. Irish whip by Johnny B. Badd and catches Slater coming off the ropes and another right into the... Johnny B. Badd, one up.
Yeah, years of experience pay. Someone sends you a telegram, you will see it coming, and Dirty Dick Slater did.
And now it's Bunkhouse Buck putting the boots to Johnny B. Badd. Punishing that rib cage, now smashing him into the turnbuckle. Irish whip reverse by Johnny B. Badd. Oh. High backdrop by Johnny B. Badd on Bunkhouse Buck. Very quick lateral press up the far leg, but too early in the match.
Right there. I mean, they got to keep making tags. You've got to keep the momentum going, especially for these two guys who rely on their speed and stuff.
You see Puck outside. You know, every time we get a shot of him, be failing faster. You can always tell if his team is on the losing end because he's got that handkerchief and he's fanning real fast. If he's fanning slow, they're doing good. If they fan it fast, see, I pick up stuff like that because I'm a broadcast journalist. I can see all that stuff. I got eyes in the back of my head. My eyes are a banquet for the eyeball.
What are you talking about?
Me picking that up. You didn't pick it up. I would know if I was on the offense, if he was fanning fast, I would say I would be winning.
Johnny B. Badd off the ropes, caught from behind by Dick Slater as he was getting set to blast away at Bunkhouse Buck.
Yeah, see, that's what would have happened to you. You would have got it in the back. It's ring positioning. They're not making enough tags here. I think Bunkhouse Buck, Dirty Dick Slater, their strategy of slowing these guys down are starting to take its toll.
Hey, Dusty, clubbering.
Yeah, they clubbering. That was a little bit of clubbering, and the clubbering got him down right there. You're right, Gordon. You were right on top of that clubbering right there. But now he's getting a mud hole stomped in him.
Look how they utilize their corner right there. I mean, these guys know what they're doing. and the human orchid is not going to stay pretty.
They dump him out in their own corner, and Johnny B. Bad outside the ring, and Colonel Parker.
Hey, Riff!
Some cheap shots there by Colonel Parker. Lion Bryan starts to come out to protest the situation, and this gives Funkhouse Buck a chance to do some more punishment on Johnny B. Bad outside the ring.
Well, we've talked about that so many occasions. You don't want to be out there. It's a place where you don't want to be outside the ring. You want to be inside there, and he's back in there. No matter if you're hurt or not, don't be left out there, especially with guys stomping on you.
Got him in a domino fit.
Again, but notice the ring positioning where Slater put this abdominal stretch on Johnny B. Bad. These guys are thinking.
Look at the extra help he's getting from Bunkhouse Buck, however, that other hand back there.
Well, that's why he's in the corner. He's thinking.
He's cheating.
He's thinking.
He's cheating.
Johnny B. Bad thus far unable to get away.
Or leverage.
Cheating. Now you got it. It's leverage.
Okay, cheating leverage.
And again, Slater reaching out, getting some extra leverage. Colonel Parker trying to divert the referee's attention.
You see that gun? He wasn't fanning there because they were in control.
Right. Couple of punches to the throat of Johnny B. Bad. The referee arguing with Bunkhouse Buck about his being in the ring.
Well, like Larry said, he staggered right back into the wrong side, and now he's out there in no man's land once again.
You talk about taking advantage of the rules. Dirty Dick Slater is an expert at it. Referee had his back turned, and out went Johnny B. Bad.
Over the top rope, which would have been an automatic disqualification had the referee seen it. Johnny B. Bad rolls back into the ring, fires a punch to the midsection, another one to the midsection. And it is Dick Slater and Johnny B. Bad swapping punches momentarily. There's a neck breaker by Slater. As Johnny B. Bad back to the canvas, lateral press. Brian Pillman breaks it up.
Yeah, you need to hit somebody. That's it, anybody.
You can see the frustration building here, but Johnny B. Bad, I mean, the strategy of Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick, they paid off. They've slowed down the team of the high flyers here, guys.
Well, we're seeing a great tag team matchup here, only getting ready for Slammery Weekend. You know, you talked about the referee a while ago, maybe being out of position. Can you imagine Hogan and Savage against Vader and Flair with the Renegade and I? Where the referee going to be? He's going to have the eyes in the back of his head on pay-per-view at Slammery tomorrow night.
That is a natural fact. Meanwhile, Slater and Bunkhouse Buck punishing Johnny B. Bad back in their own corner. Bunkhouse Buck brings him out, full scoop slam by the young man from Bucksnorth, Tennessee. And the flat of the foot across the prefrontal lobe of Mr. Johnny B. Bad.
Look, with all the endurance Johnny B. Bad has, he's not looking too good out there. This is a result of not getting enough tags in, not keeping that momentum going.
Well, he's close right there, Gordon.
Tried very hard, inches away from a tag, but couldn't get it.
Yeah, he's still got him right where he wants him, Johnny. Johnny got to really...
There you go. Come on, baby. Fire back, Johnny.
Well, I'll tell you what. Johnny B. Bad lashes out with a great boot to the midsection. And I'll tell you, this guy is a bull. And talking about bulls, the Brandon Bull. Paul Orndorff tonight on WCW Saturday night. Second round of the U.S. Heavyweight Championship Tournament against Sting. That's tonight on WCW.
Go ahead, Gunn.
Meanwhile, Flying Brian comes in, turns into a Mexican head scissors. Beautiful move by Flying Brian. And he has got this tag team combination in trouble. So maybe the strategy of keeping him out of the ring for a while was the thing to do, because, brother, he is fresh and tripped up by Parker.
I didn't see that.
Well, your ocular observation was grossly amiss there. Here comes Slater.
Yeah, Pillman really fired in there, brother. He had it rocking and rolling and was really on top of that. Made a mistake right here. Now he's down in a situation where Johnny B. Bad found himself.
Alarm dragon twist now by Slater back into side headlock. Rushing leg sweep. Beautifully executed by Mr. Slater. The crowd picking up a chant now as they're trying to encourage Johnny B. Bad and Flying Brian to pick up the pace. Gut-wrench salto by Slater.
Go.
Inverted press. Tried for a pinfall. Got a two count.
That was a two and a half. Slater's not happy about that count. I hate when referees count slow.
Once again, back on their feet, Lion Bryan.
I rammed him right back in that knee, I'm telling you. He's in a bad place. This team is in a bad situation. I'm talking about Donovan Bad and Pillman. I mean, offensively, they have not really made a big score yet, you know. Hopefully they will, but this match is taking its toll on that team. There you go. Well, I got to be unbiased, but I like that kick, Larry.
Johnny B. Bad breaking it up. Lion Bryan off the ropes, catches a boot by Bunkhouse Buck, and now Bunkhouse Buck brings Lion Bryan back to his feet. Looping right hand and drops Lion Bryan. This may be the count. Nelson broken up by Johnny B. Bad. Here comes Slater. Now we got all four of them in the ring.
Frustrations have got too high here.
Lion Bryan in trouble, caught now. Bunkhouse Buck trying to turn him into a backslide. Lion and Slater bumps into a Bunkhouse Buck, and it's Lion Bryan with the Bunkhouse in a backslide. He gets the pinfall.
What? Yes, sir, he sure did. Backed him in and rolled him up right there, kept him in that position. Yes, sir. Jimmy Van Tillman.
Wow, what a bad break for Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater. That was... Yeah. Lady Luck showed up here for these guys.
Yeah, bad break. They got beat.
It's like a fluke.
Well, they put it down in the record book. It won't say whether it was luck or what it was. It'll just say a victory for Johnny B. Bad and Flying Bryan. Let's take a look once again. We'll see what we're talking about.
Well, watch this. Bunkhouse Buck was in a good position here, but Dirty Dick just bumped into him, and the momentum took him over.
Yeah, he tried to get them shoulders down, and I'm telling you, he finally hooked him in there. That's a 1-2-3. Pillman, Mean, tomorrow night on the main event, round two. And we talk about the Sting of the night.
We'll be right back.